This little thing manages to wind his way out of my case. He's called a Niffler. He's one of my favorite beasts.
If you don't love the Niffler, there's something wrong with you. There's just something wrong with you if you don't love the Niffler. People have met Nifflers in the Potter books. So they are odd little tunneling creatures who are attracted by anything shiny.
Effectively, they're adorable thieves and create mayhem.
You don't have to see a lot and you get him, and he's very funny, he's very charming.
Yeah.
The wonderful thing about the Niffler is he's an animal, he's voracious. He looks ahead, he sort of makes do, and he goes forward, doesn't really look backward at all. He's got a funny little body, you know, he's incredibly fast and dynamic just through that speed of mind, insatiable appetite. We looked at a variety of creatures, moles, platypuses, echidnas. I think one of the creatures with greatest inspiration, probably not in terms of form, but in terms of attitude, was the honey badger, which is a sort of South African weasel.
I'm just wondering, are we going too fast?
Yeah, you need time for him to reach and go.
See that, yeah.
It's probably the most complex scene we've done, because there's a choreography of elements that need to come together. Between camera, Eddie, the extras, and puppeteers, which are creating moments.
Do a lot of prep that has been done by the visual effects department. I've got to see their pictures, their animations, and have a lot of conversations. And so it feels like I'm able to bring a lot of that knowledge and then be on set to try and make sure that the characters carries through all the way on set and all the way into post-production as well.
It inspires ideas for what they can do, how they can interact with Eddie. He's working with all these virtual creations, and it's important for him to get a sense of what his counterpart is, especially since his relationship to these animals is so strong and so important.
I sort of asked Pablo, who's like 6'4", like really, really big guy, I was like, so what would the Niffler, and he'd go, he'd basically suddenly like inhabit the Niffler. And so in the end, I was like, for the scene at the bank, when I chased him off, I was like, Pablo, can I just have you? So this literally 6'4" man, like down, like hiding behind the bank. But it was amazing.